Hello friends, this is Sangram Patil and we are here for studying architecture of 8086 microprocessor. So let's begin. Basically, this is the architecture of 8086 microprocessor. 8086 microprocessor is a 16-bit processor which is used two-stage pipeline architecture with functional blocks of BIU and EU. BIU is bus interface unit. It is a part of the processor used to fetch the instructions from the memory like RAM. EU is execution unit, part of the processor which performs decode and execution called is EU. BIU, the first logical part of the processor responsible for fetching the instruction, and it contains the following blocks. A instruction queue. There is a 6-byte instruction queue used to store the instructions of program fetched by the BIU. This queue is FIFO, that is first input, first output queue. It's like the shift register, such that BIU will fill the queue and EU will empty the queue for the execution. Because there is the flow of instruction through the queue, technique used is called as pipeline architecture. When the queue is completely filled with the program instruction, BIU will wait. It will fetch the new instructions only when some space is available in the queue, such that there is the synchronization between BIU and EU. Explaining you about the memory segmentation of architecture 8086. So we can see this is the memory segmentations of architect of 8086. It has 4 units. Memory segmentation is the memory management technique in which 1 MB of total memory is supported by microprocessor 8086 is divided into 4 logical partitions called as segments as follows. CS shows that it is a code segment, ES is extra segment, DS is data segment, and SS is stack segment. Types of segment, there are 4 types of segment as shown in the diagram with predefined functions. CS, that is code segment. This is the 64 kilobyte segment used for store code instructions of the program. Data segment. This is a 64 kilobyte of segment used to store the different operands like data of the program, like 2 input data for addition or block of the data called as source block with 70 element as an example. Extra segment. This is similar to the data segment, but it is only required to store the destination block with multiple values. It is 64 kilobyte segment. Stack segment. This is the 64 kilobyte segment used in interrupt and used to store the return address. Processor 8086 referred to every segment of the memory using a 16-bit register called as segment registers, like CSR, DSR, SSR, and ESR, which is the part of BIU as shown in the architectural diagram. Segment registers like CSR is used to store the starting address of the particular segment, like code segment, as shown in the diagram of the segmentation. We can see that on the screen. Now coming towards the execution unit. Execution unit is the second stage of pipeline architectures, such that it contains most important parts. A, that is control system. Control system is used to receive the instructions from 6-byte instruction queue and interpret the instructions. This process is called as decoding to find the meaning of the instruction. There are 2 techniques to decode instruction, like CISC and RISC. CISC is basically complex instruction set computer, and RISC is reduced instruction set computer. Processor 8086 uses CISC approach for decoding instruction. Register in 8086 For explaining registers, we can see in the diagram, 8086 microprocessor support different types of 16-bit registers visible in the architectural diagram. These registers are classified as three types as follows: general purpose register, special purpose register, and conditional GPR or SPR. General purpose register. There are four 16-bit registers such as AX, BX, CX, and DX, which are used to store any data like input values, final results, and intermediate results, address or count values. Such registers are called as GPRs. Every register GPR can be used in three ways, like AX to store the 16-bit value, or AL to store the 8-bit value, or AS to store the 8-bit value. Special purpose register. The 16-bit register like ESR, DSR, SSR, CSR, IP, and SP are used to store only the addresses of the memory, like logical address. Such registers are called as SPR because they cannot store any other data. Conditional GPR or SPR. 16-bit registers like SITI are normally used to store offset address of the data segment or extra segment or stack segment. But when these segments are not used in the program or the application, these registers are available as GPR to store any data, hence they are called as conditional GPR. ALU. It is the main processing hardware which is a part of the EU, such that ALU performs different calculations like add, subtract, multiply, divide, logical AND, OR, etc. This result generated by ALU can be stored in GPR in the memory, and such technique is called as execution of the instruction. There is the SPR called as flag register, which is linked with ALU to reflect the status of a result. We conclude with the architecture of 8086. We will move toward the flag registers of microprocessor 8086. So this is the microprocessor 8086 flag register. Flag register is the 16-bit register, also called as PSW, that is program status word, used to reflect and show the status of the final result generated by the ALU, that is arithmetic logic unit, after some calculation is performed. There are 9 flags defined in 8086 processor as follows. CF, the carry flag, is used to indicate the 17 bit, called as the carry or borrow, generated after the 16-bit addition or 16-bit subtraction. This zero flag is used to indicate and generate the zero or non-zero, such that when the result is generated is non-zero, this flag will be reset or zero. If the result generated is zero, then this flag is set to 1. AF, this flag is auxiliary carry flag, which is used to represent the carry or borrow generated after addition of lower 4 bits, which includes LSB. AF is not directly available to the programmer. It is used internally by the processor. SF, the sign flag, is used to indicate whether the result generated is positive or negative. When the result generated is negative, that is 2's complement, sign flag will be set, or 1. When the result generated is positive, then the sign flag is reset to 0. OF, that is overflow flag, which is used to indicate the result generated by the processor after some calculations out of range. It means when the result is out of range, then it is set to 1. When the result is in range of the reset is 0. PF, that is parity flag, which is used a concept called as OR parity in the processor 8086, with such that total number of 1's including the parity flag is always odd, and it's normally used for error detection. 6 flags of 8086 microprocessor like CF, ZF, AF, SF, OF and PF are called as the status flag. Then remaining 3 flags like TF, IF and DF are called as control flag. There are 3 control flags in 8086 microprocessor which are normally set or reset by the programmer or designer. IF, this is the interrupt flag of 8086 processor linked with the hardware maskable interrupt INTR such that when IF is 1 or reset maskable interrupt is enabled, it will be recognized by the processor and the processor will serve. But if the IF is 0 or reset, the interrupt is maskable and will not be served. DF, that is directional flag, is linked with the string instruction. It defines direction how data flag is referred when the DF is 0 reset. SI and DI register are automatically incremented by 1 or 2 when the directional flag is 1 set. SI and DI registers are decremented by 1 or 2. And explaining about the trap flag. Trap flag is used in step or operation to break the operation while calibrating or taking the output of the assembly program. That's all about architecture of 8086. Thank you. Yeah.